Hi guys, and welcome back to another IBRACORP video. Thanks for coming back and checking out the channel today. Pleasure to have you here. If you guys like what we're doing on the channel, please think about subscribing and hitting that like button. It really helps the channel out. And of course, you can support us on our website by signing up as a member to help us keep going. Today, we're going to be looking at Theme Park. Now, Theme Park's been around for quite a while. It's made by one of our community developers, GilbN, and we've worked with him before to bring out one of our other videos, which was setting up a custom theme for Unraid. Today though, I'm going to be showing you Theme Park, which covers themes for various different applications to get you going and really customize the look of your home automation environment. There are various themes and various apps that are supported with those themes. Here, for example, we're looking at Sonarr in all the different themes that we can get. We've got Maroon, Nord, Plex, etc, etc. There's so many there. And you can then apply those to other applications. So for example, we've got Radarr, and look at the list down the side. It's huge, massive list of supported apps and different ways to actually deploy the themes as well. So we're not locked into one particular operating system or anything like that. If you're using Docker, I think personally that's going to be the easiest way, but there are other options that are provided here by GilbN on ways to install it. So if that sounds interesting and you want to get all your automation apps set up with a beautiful looking theme, the way you want it and customize it, this is going to be the video for you. So without further ado, let's just get stuck into it. So guys, thank you very much for coming back today. This one's the one that we've been waiting on for quite a while. You also might know GilbN as the author for a very popular blog, which is Technical Ramblings. Now, I know personally, I actually followed that guide a long, long time ago, setting up, I believe at the time was Organizer, and setting up dashboards for Organizer. And at the time, this was before we even started the YouTube channel. So, you know, it's funny how small of a world it really is, because now we end up working with GilbN a couple of times. And now we're here on the docs website, which is docs.theme-park.dev. And on here, you've got all the links that you might need. We've also put up a very brief document on our own doc site just to help you with today's video. But I highly suggest, of course, you check out the official source, which is here. And you can follow all the links required. If you want to help support GilbN, please think about doing that. He's also got his Discord and donation links there on the main page. Now, probably the most important page to start off with is going to be the setup page. There's so many different methods that we can use to get the themes to apply to our apps. And you can do it from different angles. So really, it depends how you want to do this. If you're using Linux Server IO images for your Docker containers, then you can use the Docker mods functionality in order to add themes. Pretty straightforward, and honestly, is probably one of the easier ways to do it. It's a really cool implementation by the LSIO guys to have Docker mods. If you want to know more about Docker mods, we also covered it in the swag video, which is done by LSIO as well. And that allows us to add mods to swag for our reverse proxy should we want to. So the same applies, of course, to their other Linux Server IO images that support it. You've also got methods here for Hotio containers. You've also got self-host methods. You've got Docker images, rootless option, the swag Docker mod. And then we have subfilter method as well, so we can inject it through a proxy. We also have Nginx ways to inject it as well. You've got Apache, Caddy, and Traefik as well. So you have various different options. You have the stylus method, the BlackBerry theme installer, development, and community themes. Now you might be wondering, hey, what kind of apps are we going to be supported here? What kind of themes can we get? So like I said at the start of the video, here's the massive list of apps that are currently supported, and there's more to come as well. So you can see with this huge list, I reckon probably most of you will have your apps covered and will be able to set it up fairly easily. You can see here he's got a nice little legend to give you an indication on what these different apps can support, the themes can support, and which sort of, you know, setups you'd probably want to use if you're going to use them. Another thing that we can actually get is also add-ons to show, for example, a 4K logo on our Radarr and Sonarr that are taking care of 4K content. So that makes it easier to tell apart. Now that sounds like something small, right? But that can make a big difference when you're running a Sonarr for 4K and running a Sonarr for just standard definition, which is something we'll cover in the future for you guys. Then this will be able to style it a little bit differently. You'll be able to tell them apart, especially when using the same image, same version. They look exactly the same. So you might get a little confused when you're working between the two, for example. Now here's our document, which we'll put up with the video and we'll put the link down in the description. But you can see here, we've got some example installations as well. So we've got the Docker mods options for you here in a Docker compose, just to give you an example. Now this is all can be found, of course, on the official docs page. So this is just to supplement our video today, guys. Now what you can see in this Docker compose file is that line 10 will add the theme Sonarr and line 11 adds the theme option of Hotline. So that's the particular theme that we want, for example. Doesn't have to be, you guys can change that. Just add those two lines and restart your Docker container and basically we'll be done and dusted. It'll start back up with the new theme. We've also given you some of the Hotio scripts links, so that goes obviously to the official docs as well. The Nginx proxy manager link as well, the stylus method and Firefox as well. Now, stylus is a browser extension available for Chrome. So that means that we can not have to mess with anything at all on the server. We can just inject it into our browser. But there is a little bit of a downside, if you want to call it that, and that is that it will only work on the local browser where you installed stylus and added the configs. It may not be the best option for everyone, but it's a option there for you if that's something that suits you, which is cool. You know, the more options we have, the more things we can choose from. Now, here's an add-on, for example, like we're saying. So in the compose file, we can say add-on equals Radarr 4K logo, and that will give us a 4K logo. Pretty cool. So when we're starting up Radarr, it will come with that. We can add that in. Now, GilbN has also been kind enough to give us some of the words from the developer for this document. And we always appreciate it when the developers get involved with us, help us cover their app, because we want to understand it as best as possible to get it to you guys as best as possible. And that way we have a bit of a harmonious relationship. So thanks, GilbN, for filling that out. And then, of course, at the bottom, we can see where we're modifying and you can help support us there as well. So now that we've shown you what it could potentially look like, let's actually apply it to a Sonarr installation, for example, and see how it looks. So I'm pretty much going to be using this compose file here that you're looking at, and we're going to set up a new Sonarr installation. Okay, obviously I don't want to change anything with my current installation. This is just to get us going for this video. So let's jump into our terminal application. I use Termius. I know you guys ask me quite often. We're using Termius here at the moment. And that's what we're going to be using to get into our server. So let's get into that now. Okay, so here we are on our server. And as you guys can see, I've gone into as root. And we can pretty much get started now. So let's go into our location where we store all of our app data. Now, if I just type in ls, you'll see we have a bunch of folders come up there for all the different apps I'm currently running on this server. So what we're going to do is run Sonarr, but we want to run Sonarr a little bit differently. So we're going to change one of the folders and create one just for today's video. I'm going to call this Sonarr 4KK. We go ls and we can see that folder's there now. So let's go to there and then we'll cd into there. So we'll change directory into that folder. And obviously that's empty. Now we can either continue this in the terminal or we can continue this in code server using code server, which we covered in a video, guys. I always prefer to use code server. It's just a much nicer way to do things. So I'm going to go ahead and do that now. Okay, and here we are on code server. Again, guys, I highly recommend you check this out. It is a very cool way to manage your information and data from any browser in the world back home to your server. So it's really cool. Link will be put up for you so you can check that out if you're interested. Now, what we're gonna do is we found the folder we've created. So here it is, Sonarr 4KK. Let's go new file. And there we go. We've created a Docker compose YML. And I've just pasted it in the compose file that we have on our docs, which is obviously from the official docs as well. So we've got Sonarr, it's pulling the Linux server IO repository. We've got the Docker mods set here, and we're saying in the Docker mods, we want the Sonarr theme, and we want the theme to be Hotline. Now, the other thing we can do, like I said, if I just drop that a line, is we can add the add-on. So we can say TP add-on equals Radarr 4K. In this case, it's not gonna be Radarr though. It's gonna be Sonarr 4K logo. So we're gonna have the Hotline theme, the Sonarr 4K logo, and that's pretty much about it. Now for the ports, I'm gonna change that because obviously the current ports are being used. We'll say 9695, doesn't really matter, it's just for the purpose of this video. And that is pretty much our compose file, okay? Now, your actual compose file is gonna be very different, guys. Keep in mind, you might have different paths, you're gonna have different volumes. So in our case, I've mapped it to the folder that we just created earlier, and I don't really want anything going into media for this setup, but in your case, it's going to be mapping to your media location here. If you're not familiar with Docker Compose, we actually have a video in depth on Docker Compose, which will help you understand how it all works and how to use it. And I'll really recommend it if you are using Docker and currently using Docker run commands. Docker Compose will give you a much better way to control all of your containers. And really, it's one of the best ways to carry over to another server or anything like that in future. In any case, that's our file. We'll control S and we'll save that. And now let's go back to our server. And if I just type in ls, here's our Docker Compose file, we can see that, that's fine. So why don't we go ahead and bring that up. Now, of course, something you always keep learning is making sure you type in the stuff correctly. The other part we didn't update is the container name. So we want a unique container name because I already have Sonarr running. So Sonarr 4KK, for example, will do. We probably don't want to add anything else to that. So let's try it again now. And there you go. So what you're seeing there, if we just scroll up, keep in mind, I did not put minus D on the end. So I actually want to see the logs with you guys, and that's what we're looking at. So right at the start, if I just scroll up to the top, you can see the theme park mod has now been applied. You've got the theme park there, and you've also got the add-on and what theme we've selected. Now, the other thing you'll notice is it says no domain set and no scheme set. So it's defaulting to HTTPS, and it's defaulting to themepark.dev. Now, let's just go to that Sonarr instance that we've just started up and see what it looks like. I hope your eyes are ready for this one. Have a look at this. This is now our theme for Sonarr. How cool is that? Pretty impressive, I must say, and it really changes the look and feel of your application. You can also see in the top left, our logo has 4K written on it. So we can now customize and say, this is our 4K server. But what happens if we don't like this hotline theme? Maybe we want to change it for a different one. That's easy, let's go ahead and do that. So we're just gonna hit Control C and we'll stop this running container. And back in here, we've got our hotline theme. So let's change that to Dracula. You guys know I love my dark themes, and Dracula is actually a really cool theme. One of my favorites across the board. We also applied Dracula to Adminer because you can apply themes to that as well. So very similar. And there you go, we've just changed the theme. So let's bring that back up now. Docker Compose up. Applying the theme, and now on this screen we will refresh, and there you go, we now have the theme changed. How easy was that? Pretty straightforward, nothing too special there. Now, as I said, there are also other variables we can use, and those are the things that it's checking once the container's starting up. So Docker mods is one. The TP domain, so it defaults to the example. If you self-host and use subfolder, you must escape the forward slash. So this is where you would put your own domain there if you like. The type of theme, so TP theme, the community theme, whether it's true, and that's if you're using a community theme option. We'll get to that shortly. Also the add-ons, so we have add-ons that we can use. The scheme that we want to use, it's optional. Whether it's the Hotio container, also optional, and whether you want to disable the theme, also optional. Only used on some mods, for example. Now here's the examples for LSIO. Then we have the Hotio containers if you're using them. Both are great developers and create awesome templates. So it doesn't matter which image you go for out of these two, are both recommended. But these are the instructions for both, so that's pretty cool. You also have the example there for your compose if you're going to use a Hotio container. Now, if you're like some of us and you're super paranoid, you want to host every single thing from start to finish, you can do that. The instructions are here for Docker. And you also have the instructions for subfolders and all the other different reverse proxy options you can use. So if you're using a reverse proxy, we can tell the proxy to apply themes if we so choose as well, instead of the actual application. But that just gives you a different way of addressing it. You can do it from the reverse proxy option, or you can do it from each application. So you might be asking, what about community themes? So what's the difference between community themes and regular themes? So the community themes are options that are not officially supported, but as long as they follow the same variable structure as the rest of them, then it'll look fine. How do I use those themes with Docker mods? We add the environment variable that you see here. So here's some, for example, that are not officially supported, but will work. So the Infinity Stone themes, if you wanted those, there's ones called One Dark by Monklight, Blackberry themes, Pine Shadow, True Black, and Hotline Old, which is pretty cool. It's nice to see a community contribution option there as well, which is great, and a whole different bunch of options. So you can go scroll through them on the side there and you'll see what they look like. So if any of those pick your fancy over the official ones, you're more than welcome to use them as well. And probably the last thing we'll show you here is the add-ons. So we've got the 4K logo, which we just shown you. We've also got the Sonarr darker option there, the 4K logo for Radarr. Same thing again. Similar thing for Radarr, we've got darker there. Alternative audiobook logo. Bazarr, Lidar, Prowler, Whisper, Organizer. We've got the glass theme there, which is actually a really, really cool one. It's one of my favorites, actually. I highly recommend. If you guys are running Organizer, this is one of the best themes I've ever used. And I found it through technical ramblings, of course. So thank you, GilbN, for that. And then we've also got Unraid, guys. So you've got Unraid, you've got Alien, Fallout, Retro, Terminal. Now, this is what we showed in our video on this theme sometime last year. So here's the instructions all out there for you as well. Really, really cool. So for Plex, we've also got the Overseer side menu and alternative logo. Let's see what that looks like. So you can see we can actually theme our Plex instance. It's really cool. Let's go back, go to the alternative logo. Here's an actual way to change the logo for Plex. Pretty cool. But it does say to be able to switch to the logo, you must host this file yourself and change the image URL in the CSS. All those instructions are there for you. See what suits you. So guys, again, really cool themes, really cool way to customize all of our applications and get started on the right foot. You can change almost anything. The amount of apps on here is crazy, absolutely crazy. Please don't forget to give a like on the video and check out GilbN's work. His work has been really, really cool for the community. A very big advocate for open source, and we really appreciate his development time getting this all together. Feel free to go support him with a donation if you're so interested. You could find the link there as well. I'm sure we'll be doing a lot more work with these guys in future, especially with Linux.io. We have some stuff happening there, which is fantastic. We can't wait to bring that out to you guys soon. And we really appreciate your patience during this time. We're starting to get a lot more content ramping up in the background. We have a lot of beta programs happening at the moment. And if you'd like to be a part of that, feel free to join our Discord. We have beta programs all the time to get you in on videos before they happen. And that's a cool way for you to help participate and provide really important feedback. Thank you very much for tuning in to another video. We really appreciate your patronage. And I can't wait to see you in the next IBRACORP video.